They did not absolutely pulverize Betances, but he did give up those four hits, and that is a frustrating way for the Yankees to go down.
And again, it reminds you, in the absence of Aroldis Chapman, this is the way that he had tried to line things up. Get two innings out of David Robertson, who was very efficient in the sixth inning, hence he could pitch in the seventh. But the more you roll the dice with more relievers, the more chance that something could go wrong.
Right, and that's exactly what happened. Betances has been phenomenal for the Yankees this year. You look at the numbers that he's been able to put up. The batting average against him is under 150. And again, in that inning, I think some of his problem was that his breaking pitches were a little bit up, and the Blue Jays just put the ball in play. What helps make Betances so good? His ability to get strikeouts and just put batters away. In that inning, he did register one strikeout, but when he really could have used the ability of a swing and miss pitch, whether it's the fastball up or one of those breaking pitches, getting him a swing and miss, he was unable to get it. Through yesterday, it was only nine pitches, so he was obviously ready to go. But sometimes, Bob, you just don't have the feel for that breaking pitch, and I'm curious to see what Dellen might say in the clubhouse about whether or not he felt he was at his best.
Meantime, as we mentioned, looks like they were figuring out Thomas Pannone, the rookie starter for the Blue Jays, in that first inning, but things then changed. So as we take a look at the Yankees box score, in the end result, Jack, what we see is just six total hits, two runs, and again, problems with runners in scoring position as they went 0-for-4 and left five on base.
Yeah, you just kept waiting for them to potentially break through against Pannone, because he's not a guy who's up there lighting up the velocity board, so to speak. He's 88, he's 89, but you heard both John Flaherty and Paul O'Neill talk about his deception. He worked in a changeup, he worked in a curveball. This was only his fourth major league start, and he looked like a very cool and confident customer out there. The Yankees get those two runs in the first inning, and that game could have gotten away from Pannone. He did not allow that to happen, but if you're the Yankee offense, you've got to make some adjustments. You've got to figure out a way, okay, this is what this kid is trying to do here, make an adjustment, try and do some more damage. That's why I said this game was both sleepy and scary. You just had a feeling when the Yankees weren't adding on that they were leaving that door open for the Blue Jays to do something, and the Blue Jays did it.
Yeah, no margin for error, and it feels like the Yankees have played a lot of those games lately, and they've stalled, Jack, literally over their last 17, going 7-10. The offense, for the most part, has been okay. Two runs today isn't going to win you a lot of ball games. It's been the pitching in different pockets that have had the problems. And again, it goes back to a conversation you and I had on the pregame. At what point do you start building momentum as you head towards the playoffs? Because you want to feel good going in, even if it is just a one-game play-in.
Yeah, the answer to that question would be yesterday or the day before right. that or the day before that. If you're Aaron Boone, you can tell as he answers questions before and after games, he's searching for that right formula too. He knows that this Yankee team is better than it has shown. It just hasn't produced in the way the Yankees have been hoping and Boone has been expecting. I go back to something I said on the pregame. Boone said that the Yankees are aching to prove that they are an elite team. And when you look at where they are in the standings, that record tells you they are elite. But they just haven't been elite lately. And I know we talked about pitching having been a problem. The pitching wasn't the problem today. It was definitely offense. The last 31 batters to go to the plate against the Blue Jays today, the Yankees collected four hits. Their offense is better than that and needs to produce more than that against the combination of Pannone, Giles, and Leiter Jr. They just didn't do it.
Again, that's what's perplexing, right? Friday night's game, they string together a bunch of hits, five in the first. Today, two in the first. Seem like they have a kid on the ropes, and then they can't do anything against it.